On the 30th of August 2019, at the Margo Observatory in Crimea, amateur astronomer Gennady Borisov detected a new interstellar object. Yes, that's right, a new Oumuamua. Hello, Space Cats, and welcome back to my channel. In this week's video, we're going to be talking about this new interstellar object. Back in 2015, Oumuamua passed through our solar system and it made all of the headlines. Not only was it our first interstellar object, an object that came from outside of our solar system, but it also was very oddly shaped, kind of like a cigar, and astronomers estimated it to be up to about 200 meters in length. It was also traveling at 200,000 miles per hour. That's much, much faster than anything in our solar system that is typically that distance from the sun. There was a huge speculation that Oumuamua was in fact an alien spacecraft. And to be honest, I'm not surprised. We've never seen anything like this before. And it was tumbling through space and it was accelerating. The object wasn't emitting any gas, so there was no reason for it to accelerate. However, later in some papers by astronomers, they were able to explain away this conspiracy theory. Oumuamua was traveling so fast and it was incredibly dim that astronomers were only given 34 days to study it and observe it. But that's okay because we expected to see many more of these interstellar objects in the future with the upcoming and powerful telescope LSST. LSST was designed to scan the entire sky every 3 nights, so it should see everything that's moving on the sky. But no one would have guessed that the next observation of an interstellar object would come so soon. On the 30th of August 2019, amateur astronomer Gennady Borisov identified a moving object on images that he took with his 0.65 meter telescope that he custom built. Originally, when he posted this to the Near Earth Object Confirmation page, it was assigned a name of GB0024, but later it was confirmed by many of the observatories and it got updated to the name C2019Q4 and a nickname of Borisov after the founder. So Borisov was able to identify a coma even on his first image. And a coma is basically a cloud of gas and dust that is typical of comets because the icy material of a comet is evaporated off into gas. And after 2 more days with many more images, he was able to identify a comet tail. So comets typically have tails because of this coma, when the sun's solar wind pushes against it, the pressure pushes against it, it creates this kind of tail-like feature that points away from the sun. And this interstellar object had both an extended coma and a broad tail. So it was clearly a comet. This is on the contrary to Oumuamua, which didn't have a tail or a coma. So it was unlikely to be a comet and was more asteroid-like in feature. Astronomers know that Borisov is not a solar system object and that it's interstellar because it doesn't follow a circular orbit like most things in our solar system do. Objects which follow circular orbits are said to have an eccentricity of zero. Objects which follow elliptical trajectories are said to have eccentricities between 0 and 1. And objects with hyperbolic orbits, those that are like ellipses that aren't closed and that are not bound by the sun's gravity, are said to have eccentricities greater than 1. Borisov has an orbital eccentricity of 3.14 with a 15 sigma detection. That means that the chances that astronomers get it wrong is 1 in tredecillion. That's 1,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000,000, Oumuamua, Borisov is traveling extremely fast, 93,000 1,000 miles per hour. And on top of that, there is no planet orbit in its trajectory path. Lastly, we're pretty certain it's an interstellar object because it's coming into the solar system like directly into the plane. And its inclination is about 45 degrees. So we're pretty certain that it's an interstellar object and not something that originates from our solar system. From the few studies that astronomers have been able to make of Borisov so far, they found it to be slightly more red than Oumuamua, and more typical of the colors of comets from within our own solar system. Apart from Borisov and Oumuamua, there's one other interstellar object that we know of. It's called CNEOS 2014-0108. This object comes out to be at 0.45 meters in size, so it's more like a meteorite rather than a large interstellar object. But these interstellar objects are really important because potentially they could be the deliverers of life. A theory known as panspermia, which says that life throughout our universe and life on Earth was delivered via microorganisms on space dust, on meteorites, on comets, and on spacecraft. When Oumuamua was first discovered, it was already leaving our solar system, so it didn't give astronomers much time to observe it and study it. But Borisov is only just entering our solar system now. It's currently at 18 magnitude. That's not quite bright enough to be seen with the visible eye. However, it will peak in brightness in about mid-December and continue to be observable up until April 2020 with a moderate-sized telescope. So you may be wondering what I'm doing here at the National Space Center in Leicester. Well, I've been at a space conference all week, SSEA, and tonight we're having dinner inside, which is pretty cool. If you ever get the chance, I highly recommend you check out the Space Center. There's so much fun, even for adults like me. Anyway, thank you so much for watching this week's video. Let me know in the comment section below if you have any plans to go observing Borisov. I'll put some extra reading material if you're interested in knowing more about this object. And as usual, if you like this video, make sure you like, share, and subscribe.